right, y'all. So it's B-Day weekend. Mom Duke's in the building.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
You know, we just getting started. And Blogging. she said, hell no to a velo.
Hell no to a velo.
Why? What's going on with a velo? What happened?
Because they're trash.
How many delays did they have?
They had one delay, but they changed the time like 5 times for the push-off out of Orlando.
Mm-hmm. And we're here with Taylor.
Oh, and then we didn't even get water or nuts or any food at all on the plane.
On the plane. So, velo for those
no
that
snacks.
Those that haven't flew a velo yet, it's, you heard it first. No waters and no snacks.
They're picking up trash. What trash are you picking up if you didn't even deliver
it? Mm-hmm.
Taylor, you want to say hello this morning? We're vlogging. It's the B-Day weekend. They came to see me at work. Grandma's birthday coming up. They came to see me at work. Ma, they came to see me at work. Get some breakfast this morning. We're getting our day started. Headed to City Island. We're going to end it off at City Island tonight. All right, y'all. That's what it is. B-Day weekend. Mom Duke's in the building. Holla back.
R.E.B.
Yo, Jason, if you see this YouTube, you seen it for self.
Harvey.
Yeah, Taylor.
Welcome.
Wait, it ain't daytime, but we getting it right.
All right. There we go.
We headed to, as well as Mom Duke's B-Day week. So we turning up. We headed to, you know, the famous City Island. She thinks she's back home. We're going back to the Bronx. So she got the bucket.
Oh, okay.
She got the bucket hat on because we're going to the boogie down.
Wait, I gotta get my shit.
She gotta be
you
Bronx.
Still talking?
Yeah,
she gotta be Bronx. Talking. Bronxed up.
So we're going to City Island, gonna eat some good old seafood.
Oh shoot, they're the shades. Oh, okay.
I don't see nothing.
Come through.
Do you see that's black?
I'm done.
Anyway. Is this my shade? Oh, it's my shade.
Wow. All right, so we out of the city. Anybody, what's the plan? What's the eats today? What's on the menu? What we trying
seafood,
to eat?
Seafood.
Yeah, we're getting some seafood today.
Like seafood.
We're going to eat good. It's just the beginning. It's day one. Remember, Noah Velo.
And I'm already tired.
She already tired.
She ain't tired.
She better get right.
She better take a nap on this drive.
She better perk up. You see what I'm doing. Holla back. We'll see y'all in a minute. One.
Deuce.
It's recording.
What's going on? Yeah.
It's recording.
It's recording.
We're here, City Island. Kaya just hopped in the car. You know what's going on, Mom.
And it's
Duke's,
about to go down.
It's going down.
It's
going to
be epic. It's going to be epic.
Seafood City. All right. Give me a second. We're in New York. It's hollering at me. Seafood City. We on the way right now. It's going down. Big things right now.
They just met up. Look at them.
It's my boo thing.
We about to get right. Yeah, we see y'all in the field.
My stepbrother's going to be there, too. You've seen him, but you probably don't remember him. Okay.
Y'all remember Uncle Nicky?
Here's the key to everything. They not alone. They don't die alone. The kids are still in that. You know, Spanish people can't stay in the house till like they're in their 30s.
If a woman is willing
right
to
or
sacrifice,
wrong.
If a woman is willing to sacrifice
right or wrong,
happiness
yeah.
to be miserable because just so a man can be in the
you
house,
that.
That's her choice. That's not my choice. Right?
My sons didn't leave. I left.
Okay, your son didn't leave.
All three of them.
She left
them.
They didn't leave.
Hell no.
You know why? Because their moms were too fucking independent and got on the goddamn nerve. They said, let me.
No, because mama got tired of the BS.
Come on. why don't y'all just admit it that black women are too independent?
We're independent, but because it's a man that don't know how
we're to act. We're independent
I was just saying that the advancement is because, let's say, for instance, I would say a lot of times older men will go with a younger woman. Yes. But if you notice, that younger woman goes with the older man because the man of her own age, close her own age, is not ready to become that age of that woman.
Ooh, it's hard though.
All right,
so
all right.
Times,
I agree.
A lot of times, we may feel we're being bamboozled, but the point is that that woman already knew she wanted you before you knew you wanted
okay.
her.
Okay, all right. So,
not true.
So,
nuggets.
So I'm dating this girl. I'm dating this girl in Maryland, right?
Now?
She married to.
She said now.
Oh my God.
Is that now?
Behavior.
Right?
It don't get no better than this shit. Right?
Oh my God.
This is live. This is live shit right here. Live TV.
You gotta find.
She may not. She
but
may
you see it. What?
With the time.
She's a four.
I think
she's a three.
Think,
now. That's why she's a three.
See,
now.
See, there's a difference between lust and love. Let's talk about lust and love.
Yeah,
sit with that. Okay. There's a difference between lust and love. So when that comment that you made, that a woman, hold on, right? Combination. You said a woman knows what she wants when she meets a man. Man does too. Right. She don't know that man. Just like
she
that
don't
man
know that man.
They all coming together for one common cause at that time. We can get it on. Let's keep it real.
Right. Let's keep it real.
Let's get it on. Nothing else is involved. Everything else come afterwards. That pillow talk. That's when everything starts.
That's what
I could say this. All right, okay. A lot of times women are also looking for a future where a lot of times that man is not ready for a future.
I can agree with
absolutely.
That.
Absolutely.
I can agree
and
with
I'm
that.
I'm just saying this because we talk about a certain age. Let's say, for instance, this woman is 30 years old and this man is 30 years old. That man ain't ready yet.
They ain't ready yet.
All right. But
absolutely.
She already is.
Why? Because 30.
No.
Because 30, a man is just feeling himself at 30. Yes, at 30. A woman want to settle down.
Hold on, man.
Go ahead,
you're right.
Tony.
You're right.
She already has figured out.
Right.
When she has planned to do whatever she wants.
I absolutely
she found
agree.
A man that's responsible and he's doing the right thing. Okay? When she finds a man that's doing what he's supposed to be doing as a man, standing up, she sees potential in that man. She will do the right thing for him and with expectations. Because him being an older man, he's already been seasoned.
But see, that's a woman.
You better hit.
But hold on. Hold on. Let's talk heavy. But that's a woman's flaw.
That's
a woman's flaw. You want to know why? Because women wear their emotions on their sleeve. Right? So when you wait.
You got the answer.
I'm just saying. This is facts. Women wear their emotions on their sleeve. They're more emotional than men. Men come out. Women are like, oh, I want a man off the rip before they even meet a man.
Right.
When they're getting dressed, when they're getting dressed to go to the club, they're like, I can find me a man tonight. Right or wrong? I need a man. I need a man tonight. Right? That's the women.
They wear the shortest dresses.
Men is going out like, yo, I want some ass tonight. You know? It's a big difference.
Big difference.
As far as what?
As far as how many women out there to each man?
That is fucking true.
Oh,
I ain't gonna lie.
All right. 5 to 1.
There's a dozen for him.
And then when you got a homo, that make another 5. But it's 10 to 1.
At least 8 to 1. So if a man settles down with that particular woman, he knows what he got.
Oh yeah,
right.
But can I
say it? Something on the young
question.
Woman and the older man situation?
That's the question.
The figure, your man saw a little this, a little that. But did you see the whole thing?
Yeah, but the younger women and the older man situation. Let's deal with that.
We're looking at one simple thing that we want.
Well, these days women act like men.
That's right. They go out. I don't care. I'm one of them. I'm a straight man.
What'd you say, Kaya?
I'm a straight man.
Straight woman, man. What about what
you want
about that? See, you're coming from an old woman, but that's a new era right now. That's why it's not working like that.
Can I tell you something?
We're living in a new era.
Yeah, but
Looks
have changed.
Look,
the
era's
different.
Yeah,
it is.
The
era now with these
they
kids
me. I'm
61
years old.
You know what I'm saying?
I gotta have a good looking motherfucker. I don't need substance. I don't need a woman to give me substance. just look good. Walk around the house and look good. Wear them things and look good. I don't want substance. Listen, at 61 years old, I don't want substance.
But I see what he's saying based on
that. You understand?
I understand everybody.
I'm telling you, as a 61-year-old man, I don't want nothing substance. I just want a fat ass, big substance.
I'm done.
Let's roll.
Done.
But you know what? A woman my age, look. A woman my age can still go to the television and throw something on the floor and bend down and let
that young woman gonna leave your ass. She gonna leave your ass.
What?
Yo, she's gonna leave your ass. You can never leave. That young girl gonna leave.
I still know how to do all that. You don't need no young chick for that. Oh, yeah.
I want to hear it.
Yeah, but it looks so much nicer on a 35-year-old.
When I first walked with him, she would tell you that I said, he's my husband, he just don't know it yet.
Okay.
I knew that.
Men say that too, though.
Men say that same shit.
Men be like, maybe that's my wife. She don't know that.
Yeah.
You know what? And you gonna be my wife. Mad, then we get married to this dusty motherfucker. We be like, damn.
God damn.
No, but I'm just saying, you just make your listen to me.
I'm just trying to figure out why she got to be dusty.
We all dealing. You know, we having a conversation, right? And the conversation takes a lot of different
ways. Yeah, but you just said you got a five and then a Maryland woman. What is that?
Okay, so the Maryland woman married a man that's 70-something years old.
Right? Oh, so she needs
she's 40. She's 40, right?
She's 40. She's at five.
Her husband, he got dementia, right?
So I
shoot down to Maryland. I knock her off. She gets the hotel room. She give me a little money, and we go do what we gotta do.
You're a prostitute.
No, I'm not a prostitute. But I've been dealing with her since she was 18 years old.
Well, goddamn.
Right? But what happens is, the old man got old on her.
And she's still vibrant.
And she's still vibrant.
Right? So it's different circumstances.
So what I'm just saying, I'm telling you this. This is different circumstances.
Lemon talk.
I already ate mine.
All right. What did you do? You killed that lemon? You like
yeah,
it?
Good, right?
And what did you do? What did you do to this? This pan right here.
Hold on, here.
We're in City Island, y'all.
We're at City Island, everybody.
One, two, three, go.
She eating a lemon right now. Hold up.
And now she ain't even.
Oh, she ain't even flinching now.
She's killing it.
She ain't even flinching.
Oh, and this ain't even for
no money. Yeah. This ain't even for no money. This for candy.
Yeah, for
she
candy.
Want the candy.
This for candy.
Good job.
All right, so this is us leaving City Island. Taylor mad because she just got told off by grandmama. No, that's what it is. Sometimes you got to get checked. Sometimes you don't get. That's just how it go. But for the most part, we had a great time. Shout out to Uncle Mickey. Mecca came in the building. Kaya, Akmel. He turned it up for City Island today. Claudia, my cousin Akmel's girl came. We had some seafood, we had some Henny Coladas, and we was talking heavy as you can see.
Banging.
So we headed back. So I gotta do a little DJ set. We're gonna call it a night and get ready for tomorrow. So we'll see y'all tomorrow. Deuces.
All right, y'all, day two. Just pulled up to my grandfather and Nana's house in Poconos, East Stroudsburg, Pennsylvania. About to spend some time with them. Don't get to see them too often, so very important while Mom Dukes is out here that we took a ride out to go see family, you know? So family is very important. Got to stay close to them. Got to stay in contact. So that's what we're doing. Show you a little bit of the house right now.
All right, so we are actually at Granddaddy's house, man. Feeling great. Imagine summer in the Poconos. I used to come here a lot when I was younger. Basically grew up in this house. My grandfather would come get me and my cousins for the weekend, and we would just be in La La Land, be in Dreamland, man. And you're about to see why I say that. Y'all gotta excuse me, I'm a little out of breath right now, but making it happen. But my grandfather actually cuts this whole yard by himself. He cuts this whole yard by himself, 85 years old, pushing 86. It's a riding lawnmower, but the point is he still gets out here and cuts his whole lawn by himself. Yeah, man. It's all about living good and living at peace. You know what I mean? Let's go say what's up to the people. See what we got back here. There they go. There my people go right there. Just in time for the pool. How's everybody doing over here? We eating fish sandwiches.
From D'Amato's,
recommended by Granddaddy.
Yes.
Because he went down on Whaley Avenue and walked all the way down Whaley Avenue.
Oh, my God.
And got approached by a hooker.
Oh, Lord.
But the thing is, he never forgot the fish. So we had to get the fish sandwiches, brought them down to Stroudsburg. All right, all right. And we eating good. How you feeling, Queen? Bday week. Feeling good? How you feeling, Chocolate?
Feeling good, feeling good.
You about to get in the water?
About to get in this water.
We said we about to get in the water. We about to get a little drippy.
A little drippy?
A little drippy. We got Munchkin over there. She's showing them legs. She mad when I start singing. She's showing them legs. I'm getting in, all right? I'm about to change my stuff. We got Nana over there making sure the vest is nice and strapped. And it's going down. We'll catch up with y'all in a minute. Hey, Taylor. She's showing them legs.
I'm recording.
Set. Hold on.
It's start.
They don't think I can do it. I can swim underwater from here to there.
Well, underwater is easier.
So, y'all ready for this? Let's see if I still got the job.
All right, all this talking. Uno, dos, tres.
Go.
Wow, look at that.
Okay, fishy fish. Shark. Yeah. Go ahead.
Oh. Yeah.
You know me. Just chilling. Just vlogging.
I'm going in.
What am I doing? Just chilling.
I ain't doing no dance. All right, now.
Yeah,
I
buddy.
See.
Nana's in there. She's in.
I see you just
hopping. She's
up
in.
Yep.
Oh, yeah.
This was one of my things my husband got
for me. What we got right here?
Very nice. I had hot flashes.
There she is.
Yep.
Hey, how you feeling?
Sure,
how you liking it?
I stayed in.
Where you at?
Right here. Yeah.
Where, though?
Uh-huh. In the pool.
Granddaddy and Nana house.
Huh?
Granddaddy and Nana house, right?
Yeah.
You having fun?
You know
how to say? Yep. You having fun?
It's not. I'm drinking wine. Yes.
And the person that's recording this is trying to drown me.
Mama T, I am drinking mine.
We got this one hopping along. Talking about
I'm drinking
her.
It.
Nana, how you feeling? You feeling good in there?
Yeah.
All right. How's the water? How's it feeling?
It's cold, but I'm making it.
We making it. We making it do what it do. We got the chicken over there. We got the chicken over there. She said she ain't getting in. But it's all good. We going. She said she ain't getting in. There they go. Look at that. She said, me and my daddy. Y'all rebelling? Y'all non-poolers?
She was the right person. Her father don't get in the pool.
He don't get in the pool either,
no.
Right?
The one time he got in the pool, I thought he was a bear.
You thought he was a bear when he got in the pool?
Yeah, because he never gets in it.
Oh, Yo.
Never gets in the pool.
To you, happy Father's Day to you. Happy Father's Day, dear
Granddaddy.
Happy Father's Day to you.
Woo! Yeah.
Yeah.
Best granddaddy in the world.
Yes. He's the best husband in the world.
Hey.
So I get on
look
the
at
stage.
That cheese. All right. Cut it on down.
Look at Taylor. She's like, yeah. We got enough plates over there?
Yeah, if we don't like that more.
Happy Father's Day, Kate.
Granddaddy.
There we go. All right, this is what we got going on. If you want pina colada, this is how we do it. Coming soon. She's about to do some pina coladas. So, headed back. This came from the Poconos to see Granddaddy and Nana. Everybody's pool tailors back there in pool. Jackie looks tired. Beef looks tired. She don't let her fool you. It's 2 seconds later, she'll be like this. She'll be like, hey, Kevin. She don't let her fool you. We headed back. We'll get back with y'all later. Peace.
All right, we are day three. Just me and Mama D today, though. Just us. We're about to get ready to head up to Rhode Island. We just got done having breakfast, but sorry, guys. I didn't get the chance to record the breakfast. My bad. But how was your breakfast?
It was delicious.
Delicious?
Delicious.
What did you have?
I had shrimps and grits with chunks of bacon in it and a Bloody Mary with bacon.
Ooh,
a good conversation.
That sounds like that was delicious.
No, it was delicious.
Oh, it was delicious, y'all. Delicious. So we heading up to Rhode Island to see the kiddos and the grannies. And then, you know, so do a little sightseeing up there. We'll show y'all what's that all about. But until then, we'll holla back.
Holla.
Get some recording of this. All right, we are in Watch Hill, Rhode Island. Ah, sorry. That's the golf course.
Oh my gosh, it's so beautiful.
We're about to come up to the houses. I know you guys are seeing nothing but. This is Musquamica Club.
That's the country club.
Uh-huh. You see some houses coming along right over here.
Oh,
see the houses.
Gosh. Is there somebody behind you?
Uh-uh. All right, we're in Watch Hill. We're down by the water.
This is so New England. So New England.
All right, peoples. Why look cross-eyed? We are dressed for today. This is day number four.
Day number what?
Ooh, is somebody looking different?
Faux.
Is somebody looking different?
Different.
Ew. Ew. She looking cute. Don't worry. Don't worry. We about to get right ahead on my friend house, Miss Don Z. Have some cocktails and all that good stuff. You guys will see all that too as well. But we about to get ready to have a good time. Y'all see a little bit.
Bye-bye.
You enjoying yourself?
Yes.
She said you asked that one more time, she gonna punch both of us. Peace out.
Good. All right now. Yeah.
You're fancy.
Thank you.
Yes.
Yes.
You know, I gotta record. I gotta record.
No, I charge.
No, you don't charge shit. You don't charge shit.
I don't know what kind of drink people she done made. But she made this drink, y'all. She got a little honey, some little sugar, some little. Probably all these is in there. I'm gonna tell you that. No, what is this called?
It's called Summer Mango.
Summer Mango.
Look. Oh, shit. She even got started, y'all.
I ain't tasting it.
How is it?
That's delicious.
I stayed up for 2 weeks eating these mangoes.
The lies you tell.
So what is it called?
Summer Mango.
That's very good.
Oh my gosh. That's why I said if you have a particular white or brown you like.
And there's no repeats
as far as.
No, she has like two or three of each.
I see my bourbon already.
Oh, so. Jesus.
Okay,
grab that. We can take that upstairs.
Fun.
Oh my gosh.
Y'all, she in heaven.
So, okay, so this is number one.
This is her refrigerator. Oh, wait.
This is number one. You're number two, mm-hmm. And I'm minus zero.
Wait. You ready?
Oh, my God. Can I walk you? Oh, my God.
Look. Wait.
She got the Modelo.
Yes, Corona.
She got the Corona.
Yes.
She got the Heine.
Yes. Yes, whatever you need.
I have my own cigar collection.
Oh, she's learning. Yes.
Wait, remember.
I told you. She's learning cigars.
Can we light a cigar?
Yes.
She's learning cigars.
Oh, I got you.
But wait.
To cry.
Look at the nip box.
Oh, my God.
The nip box.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
The nip box.
Donzie. Yeah.
Then this is her cigars collection over here.
Oh, my God.
This is her cigars collection.
This is my spot. This is where I come when I just... So when COVID hit, I said, you know what? I got you. And during the summer, I opened the door. And I'll be on here at 2, 3 in the morning.
Jackie and Donzie.
This is her. Everybody, this is her she shed.
That's the grill that I'm trying to get rid of. Jackie, don't y'all want another grill?
So what about this? Do you like the fireplace?
I love it. So, yes. But,
wait.
So wait. I cannot put.
That's her humidor.
Yeah, that's my humidor. But in here, that's more beer.
Oh, that's her beer.
And wine and stuff. Yeah.
Yeah. She got her. She got her bourbon, y'all.
But no, I put the. I put the candles and stuff because I lit it one time and fell asleep. And you see that black? This used to be all black. It was soot. I had to have everything taken out, completely wiped off, repaint some of the walls. Because the soot.
Oh, my God.
So, yeah. So, no, we can't. So, now I just put candles in there.
So, can you cut up that? You don't cut off the other end?
No.
Okay.
No. You just caught the tip off. Uh-huh. So, this is a pointed cigar. So, that's why I use a brown one and I cut the tip.
And how far back do you go when you cut?
About yay far.
Okay.
Right? And then for cigars like this, that are round at the end, the round cut is okay. But I find when you cut the round cut, if you cut too much of it and you start to inhale a little bit, you get the particles. And I don't want that, right? So I prefer either a punch, which punches a little hole. This is what it looks like. Right?
Ooh, almost like a little thing to get a biopsy.
Yeah.
Okay.
So you literally, you can do a punch, right? If you don't want to do that, then my favorite of all time is called a V-cut. The V-cut, you see that? It gives you a really clean cut. So you put it right here. You can't go any further. So you put the cigar, see the opening? Mm-hmm. As far as it goes, and you press. You see how you get that V-cut?
Oh.
Nice and clean, right?
Uh-huh.
So here's that. Now, when you light your cigar, it is customary, depending on the age. Like, I know I've had mine a while. So
wait a minute. So stop right there. Mm-hmm. So you keep them in a temperature control.
Yeah.
That's called a humidor.
So you have electric humidors and non-electric humidors.
What's the...
These are better because it's more temperature control. With these, you have to constantly, at least every 30 days, you got to make sure that you keep your wood in here moist. So you can buy these packets, which work great, or you can use distilled water.
And spray?
No, you don't spray. So when you first get a brand new wood humidor, you want to take a clean towel sponge, get you some distilled water, and you want to just wipe, you kind of want to soak it down.
That's already too much work.
Yeah. Let the wood absorb it. Right? Once you treat it, then you can use like a little shot glass. Fill it halfway up, depending on the size of your wood humidor, and keep it in to keep the moisture in so your cigars don't dry out.
So how did you learn all of this?
Sitting around a butt.
She go to the doggone. She go so down to member, the cigar, the cigar doohickey.
Yes, of the cigar lounge. I'm
I
a
think
member
it's very
now.
Sexy when women. Yeah.
So, and because I've learned through the years how to do that, I'm good friends with a guy that actually makes cigars, which is great because he's taught me a lot too over the years. So here's the cigar that you had in your humidor, right? One of the good things to do to tighten the leaf is before you light it, you just want to go up and down your cigar. That's what you want to do. She's like, can't do mine.
No, I'll do it. If you
ready? Yeah. Just turn it. There you go. All right. And then you let it sit a minute. That helps to tighten the leaf.
Okay.
So it gives you a good snug. That way you get a good pull. And once you let it sit, you light it. And that's what you want. You want it to be good and round as you inhale. So when you pull, you see that?
Mm-hmm. Do you have to keep lighting it throughout your pulls? Depending on how long you let it sit.
Right. Because eventually it will go out if you do let it sit too long. If it's too dry, same thing, you're going to have to. And a couple of months ago, about 6 months ago, I threw away about 40-some cigars because I thought it was mold.
But it wasn't.
It was sugar. Right.
It wasn't.
And I found out it was the sugar from the leaf coming out. And those are when they're the best. So now, if they are, they just stay in there. And then I've learned how to... I take and I flavor some of my cigars. Like, smell it. Mint leaf. So I just like mint, don't I?
Mm-hmm.
Mint leaves. So what you do is you get an airtight container and you gotta put at least a little cup of water in there, like distilled water, a little shot glass. And I threw mint leaves in there and I kept it in there for 60 days. And by the time you get done and you pull them out, when you smoke, it's just like smoking on a piece of meat.
What other flavors have you used?
Cognac. I've done Hennessy and honey with sugar and cinnamon. So good. I did 40. I did 40. They are gone. With troll friends and smoke them all up. But yeah. But what you do is you buy the most inexpensive cigars and you flavor them however you want.
Recommendation be for me.
So guys, we are getting a class on cigars.
My
eyes are a little puffy underneath, but oh well, it is what it is. But anywho, we're getting a little class on how to smoke cigars.
So it depends on what you take. If you like,
but I wouldn't know until I started testing.
Right. So this is before you leave, I'm gonna give you a little bag. So we're gonna try this one.
Okay.
Right? And then that's a medium body. And then the
what
light
kind
body.
Of cigar is this?
Hey!
me. Maddie, use it. Sex gang, stupid.
Yes, I took that fucking slipper off.
Why
I took the slipper off.
Let me go in.
I took that shit off.
Let me get myself together. Today's a big day. Headed to baby girl graduation. I'm about to cry. We went through a long ride, but she made it. Very, very proud. Excited. You guys ready to see India walk that stage?
Ready.
She ready, Ma?
Ready.
We'll see you in a minute, India. Walking that stage. Oh, yeah. Love you, girl. Mwah.
I'll start recording.
Tamia Housley.
That's good.
India Osmia.
Yeah! India!
Aya Washington. Isaiah Patterson. Alexander Rodriguez. Zania Hawkins with honor. This is the last time I can tell you what you're doing. You have to listen to me. So, for the class of 2022, please stand. I would like to introduce our esteemed board member, Dr. Abby Benitez, who will confirm the diploma. Woo! Yeah, I'm not finished.
Oh my Lord.
Finally made it to Chowder Pot. These lovely ladies surprised me for Father's Day. Had a good meal. We've been vibing out all week. Still getting it going. Got tonight to go. Yeah? We'll see you in a minute.
I'm